Let's stand and sing together our opening song, Remain Still and Warm.
Hear the prayers of those who call upon you. We ask, O Lord, and forgive the sins of those who confess to you, granting that in your kindness both pardon and peace. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Said to him, Now that you are old and your sons do not follow your example, appoint a king over us, as other nations have to judge us. Samuel was displeased when they asked for a king to judge them. He prayed to the Lord, who said in this answer, Grant the people's every request. It is not you they reject, they are rejecting you as their king. Samuel delivered the message of the Lord in full to those who were asking him for a king. He told them, The rights of the king. Who will rule you will be as follows. You will take your sons and assign them to his chariots and horses, and they will run before his chariot. He will also appoint from among them his commanders of groups of 1,000 and of 100 soldiers. He will send them to do his plowing and his harvesting, and to make his implements of war and equipment of his chariots. He will use your daughters as ointment pickers, as cooks and as bakers. He will take the best of your fields, vineyards, and olive and give them to his officials. He will take their crops and vineyards. and give the revenue to his eunuchs and his slaves. You will take your male and female servants, as well as your best oxen and your asses, and use them to do his work. He will take your flocks, and you yourselves will become his slaves. When this takes place, you will complain against the king, whomever you have chosen. But on that day, the Lord will not answer you. The people, however, refused to listen to Samuel's warnings and said, "Not so. There must be a king over us. We too must be like other nations, with a king to rule us and lead us in warfare and fight our battles." When Samuel had listened to all the people had to say, he repeated it to the Lord, who then said to him, "Grant their requests and appoint a king for them to rule." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. The word to them. They came bringing him a paralytic, carried by four men. Unable to get near Jesus because of the crowd, they opened up the roof above him. And after they had broken through, they let down the mat on which the paralytic was lying. When Jesus saw their faith, he said to them, "Child, your sins are forgiven." Now, some of the scribes were sitting there asking themselves, "Why does this man speak that way? He is blaspheming. But who but God alone can forgive sins?" Jesus immediately knew in his mind what they were thinking to themselves. So he said, "Why are you thinking such things in your hearts? Which is easier to say to the paralytic, 'Your sins are forgiven,' or say, 'Rise, pick up your mat and walk'? But that you may know that the Son of Man has authority to forgive sins on earth." He said to the paralytic, "I say to you, rise, pick up your mat and go home." He rose and he picked up his mat at once. And when they went away in the sight of everyone, they were all astonished and glorified God, saying, "We have never seen anything like this." The Gospel of the Lord. Today's message is, be careful who you pay attention to, because who you pay attention to can either help you for good things or can help you for not such good things. Why do I say pay attention? Well, because in this reading from Samuel, you know, Samuel was the king. And he was getting old. And the people around him didn't want him as king anymore. For no good reason, but he was just getting old. See, you have to understand that Samuel was a follower of Jesus. And in order to be a good king, he prayed to the Lord God. Right? He was a follower of God. This is before Jesus, sorry. He was a follower of God. And he prayed to God to be the best leader he could. And he tried to deliver to his people God's message on how you should live your lives. And so they rejected him. And he's praying to God. And God is saying to Samuel, "Don't take it personally. They're rejecting me, not you. Here's the message that I want you to give your people." And God was giving the people the message through the King Samuel that this next leader isn't going to care for you like the present leader, Samuel. And so he talks about all these things that's going to happen to the people when they get that next leader who didn't care about them. Pay attention, because in your life, God is going to send you people that you need to pay attention to who are going to help you be the best you can as a follower of Jesus. And then there are going to be some other people who aren't going to be good for you. Well, how do you figure out who's good for you and who's not good for you? That's where prayer comes in. If someone wants you to do something and it doesn't feel right inside, don't do it. And pray to Jesus. When you come here, hopefully you come a couple minutes early before Mass or during the Mass, you pray, "Okay, someone asked me to do something, Lord, and it doesn't feel right." Talk
He will give you the direction for the best decision you make. Or somebody's going to ask you to do something you're not sure about. Bring it to prayer. I don't know about this, Lord. And then you'll get the answer that, man, through prayer, you say, no, this is a good thing. Right? It's so important to do that. And then if someone wants you to do something exciting, tell the altar servers, don't decide too fast. When you make decisions too fast, not all the time, but many times, it's not the best decision. Because you go so fast that you miss something. And I've learned that. When I really want to do something, I go really fast. I don't think it out, and I miss something. And so it's good to kind of think out. Think out our steps, right? Think it out a little bit. And it can serve you greatly when you think things out. It's kind of like, life is kind of like playing checkers. Have you ever played checkers before? Have you been checker players? Ever tried checker? How about chess? Right? And you sit there and you're playing chess, right? And the other person's saying, hurry up, come on, go. Well, why are they saying that? Or in checkers, hurry up, go. Because they know what that move is to beat you. And they want you not to make that move because they want to beat you, right? Hurry up. Right? Just wait a minute. There's no timekeeper here. And then you see it, right? That's kind of like life. Take it slow. Bring it to prayer because Jesus is always with you. The Lord God is always with you. Just like in Samuel. The Lord God is always with Samuel to help Samuel be the best leader. The Lord will always be with us to help us be the best leader. But we got to follow him. And following Jesus is called what? You know what that is? When you follow Jesus, you're called what? What do you think? What's a follower of Jesus called? I'm going to repeat this over and over. Just say it out loud.
A disciple.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. I can even hear him in the classrooms over there. A disciple. Right? A disciple is a follower of Jesus. You trust Jesus. You get to know Jesus. And you heed his call. And then you do the best you can do. And when you make a mistake, you make a mistake. And it's all okay. Because you learn from those mistakes. You say, oh, Jesus, I made a mistake. Help me to do the better. So that's today's message. Pay attention to those around you, those who help want to help you be the best you can be, like your teachers, and those who may not have your best interests. Let us offer our prayers for the needs of our world, our country, and our community of faith, as we invite Jesus into our hearts to help us to help other people.
Please respond, Lord, hear of her. For the Holy Catholic Church, for Francis our Pope, Blaise our Bishop, and for all the bishops, priests, deacons, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the leaders of the nations, that they will promote life, peace, and justice, and work together for the common good, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Community and its needs, that we would open ourselves to the transforming message of the gospel and heed the call of Christ. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are sick, suffering, and poor, an end to the pandemic, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who have died and for our own deeds and intentions, that we not recall in the silence of our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Gracious and loving God, help us to always heed your call as we follow you as our disciples, offering up all of our prayers through Christ our Lord. brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Father Almighty. We offer you, O Lord, the sacrifice of conciliation and praise, that being moved to compassion, you may both pardon our offenses and direct our wavering hearts, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For you never forsake the works of your wisdom, but by your providence are even out work in our midst. With mighty hands and outstretched arm, you led the people of Israel through the desert. Now as your church makes her pilgrim journey in the world, you always accompany her by the power of the Holy Spirit and lead her along the paths of time to the eternal joy of your kingdom, through Christ our Lord. So with the angels and saints, we do sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Jesus took the chalice that was filled with wine. He thanked you and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Jesus has given his life for us. The mystery of faith. Lord our God, listen. listen to our many prayers. Send the Holy Spirit to all of us who share in this meal. May the Spirit bring us closer to the family of the Church. Together with Francis, our Pope, Blaise, our Bishop, all other bishops, and all who serve your people. We praise you, we bless you, we thank you. Remember, Father, our family and friends, and all those who do not love as we should. Remember all those who have died. Bring them home to you to be with you forever. We praise you, we bless you, we thank you. Gather us all together into your kingdom. There we shall be happy forever with the Virgin Mary, Mother of God, her spouse, Saint Joseph, and our mother. There all the friends of Jesus will sing a song of joy. We praise you, we bless you, we thank you.
Reuben and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
You too.
Jesus, I believe that you are present in all holy sacrament. I love you above all things and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you are already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never let me be separated from you. Amen. Let us pray. Grant us, merciful God, that receiving in the gift of the forgiveness of sins, we may be able by your grace to avoid sinning from now on and to serve you in sincerity of heart through Christ our Lord. So to serve you in sincerity of heart is by listening to the Lord, especially when we get all these things we're thinking about in our head. This person says do this person says do that, and it's big stuff. And so always go to the Lord, always pray to the Lord, ask for his guidance, and he will give you guidance. Be the best you can be. Peace of the Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go in peace.
Let's sing together our closing song. bless that wonderful